95.1.
John Butler.
Hey, John Butler here on The Bee, and I have with me two special guests from the Motor Trend Network. You've probably seen them if you've been watching the Motor Trend Network. Iron Resurrection is a great program. We've talked to Shag before from Iron Resurrection. Shag, welcome to The Bee.
Hey, thanks for having me back, man.
How are you surviving with the quarantine?
You know, I'm a bit high risk, so I have been staying in for the last, however long we've been staying in, I've been staying in. So I've been fine with it. I've got a cool family, which is good. I love my lady, so that always works. So yeah, it's actually been a lot of fun.
Yeah, that helps a lot.
yeah. So, when you like the people you live with, it makes it easier.
And our other special guest is Bogie. Bogie from All Girls Garage on the Motor Trend Network. Bogie, welcome to the program.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
How are you doing with the quarantine?
Oh my goodness. It's a crazy roller coaster, isn't it? Like, I'm just grateful that I'm not on the front lines. I'm grateful that I am, you know, not having to deal with like any major crises in my life. And I'm, I guess in a sense, even though I have no income right now, I'm one of the lucky ones in the grand scheme of things. So I count my blessings, and I'm grateful for everyone out there who's still essential workers and putting their lives on the line to keep things going, take care of people.
Yeah, I mean, who could have thought we'd be in this situation? You mentioned no income. There are a lot of folks with zero income right now, and it's going to be tough coming back, especially the restaurant workers, to name one group. But
so many, the whole supply chain. I mean, it's just crazy when you think about it. It's going to be fascinating to watch this all unfold over the next several months.
Well, it really is, because when the restaurants do open up, for to name one specific area that's hurting, are people going to flog back to the restaurants? I don't know. And the other question is, are they going to have to cut? Well, they probably will have to cut the capacity in the restaurants, probably to half or whatever, for social distancing. So,
it's
going to be interesting to watch.
Going to be very
A good friend of mine owns a chain of arcade bars in Denver, Colorado, and we were just talking about that. Like, hey, when you do open back up, what's that going to look like? It affects your entire concept as a whole.
Yeah.
You know, you're an arcade restaurant bar. Now everybody's spread out, where that's normally a very, you know, intimate gathering, intimate surrounding. So it's going to change the dynamic quite a bit on a lot of things.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Okay. Well, you got a lot more viewers, I know, because people are staying home watching TV. they're going to tune it over to the Motor Trend, channel for all of us who are interested in automobiles and anything related. So, Bogie, tell us about your show, the All Girls Garage.
Yeah. So All Girls Garage has been, crazily enough, we're in our ninth season. So 9 years of All Girls Garage going strong.
Amazing. And,
it's myself and right now just one other woman. We started out as a three woman team, and we've had some changes over the years. At the moment, I'm the last original OG host, still on the show. And myself and actually a friend of mine who I'd worked with previously, Faye Hadley, is my co-host, and we work on some just crazy cool projects and do stuff, kind of a wide range of things. We're not doing crazy builds like Shag's doing over there. Like, they're doing crazy stuff. We're doing more simple builds, like things that folks could do at home, and really kind of walking them through the process and educating along the way, having some fun. And
give me an example of one of your builds.
Oh goodness. I mean, we do everything from doing regular maintenance on cars to putting a supercharger kit in, or changing a supercharger pulley to create more horsepower, or doing a lift kit on a Jeep, or lowering a vehicle, or, you know, it's we do like a modification or a repair versus like a whole restoration, or, you know, the crazy, stuff that Iron Res does.
You're not just another pretty face on TV. You've got a background in this area.
Tell
the folks a little bit about your credentials.
Yeah, so I'm
do we have that kind of time?
Condensed version.
Real life, real short.
Yeah, the short version.
Technician my entire life. I've been an automotive technician. I was I graduated from UTI and then went to the BMW STEP program. Was a factory dealer trained BMW technician for many years. Ran an independent repair shop for about 13 years. And now I run all female restorations at my new shop, where we bring together women pros and women newbies together to build vehicles and learn all about cars and share their love and passion.
Thank you.
What is it? What's it called?
Girl Gang Garage.
That's right. That's a rad name.
If you've just tuned in, I was getting buggy on the program this morning, along with Shag. Shag, how are you doing? We talked before by phone on the program. It's good to have you here on Zoom.
Well, man, I appreciate you having me too. It's since we last talked, we've actually got some good news as well. You know, the season four has finished up, so we've aired all of season four, and just found out this week that they're bringing us back for a fifth season. So,
wow.
Yeah, here's
that's,
the thing.
That's amazing.
Because of everything that's
happened. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. But we just don't know when we'll start production or how many episodes that will be, just based on the current state of everything. But it is good to know and calming to know that we will be able to continue doing what we're doing on TV. So it's I'm looking forward to it. We just don't know when it's going to happen.
Yeah. Well, and you film in Austin, right?
We do. We film kind of all over Central Texas. You know, the shop's located about 20 miles west of Austin. So yeah. we shoot at the shop, and then we shoot just anywhere we can find stuff. So it tends to be a pretty large circle right in the middle of Texas.
Okay. And again, if you just tuned in, I'm talking to Shag from Iron Resurrection on the Motor Trend Channel. Shag, give us kind of an example of the kind of builds that you guys do.
Man, that's a good question. It's really just, all of our builds are customer builds. Joe does have a love of the Chevy Nova, and I feel like we've done a C10 and a Chevy or a Nova in every season. So those tend to show up quite a bit around the shop. But really, it's just anything that's cool, and it's a challenge. Everything's a customer build, and we have a lot of builds on the burner. So we hand select the ones that make the show, and those are based upon not make and model, but just the type of modifications that'll be done. Like, is it if we can't do all frame off builds because we just don't have that kind of time for a season?
Yeah.
So Joe hand selects with the guys what kind of builds they want to showcase the different craftsmanship in the shop.
Yeah. Well, I
hope that answered the question.
Oh, yeah, you know.
I'm dealing with a fly all of a sudden. I've been totally fine all morning right when you talk to me. Fly shows up.
About what time can people find you on the Motor Trend Network?
Well, right now it's all reruns, so it's random.
Yeah.
You know, but we are also on the app. You can watch all the seasons and all the extras on the app.
Okay, how do they find the app?
Bogey is my Saturday morning cartoon show. all girls is every Saturday morning, guaranteed.
And we have one new episode still to air of All Girls Garage. So this Saturday morning, there is a new episode that'll air, and then we'll
what
be in reruns. I can't tell you. You've got to watch.
Come on, tease.
It's one that's been on before. That's the tease. We've worked on it in the past, and we brought it back in to do more work to it.
So return visitor, tease. Huh? Nice.
Return visitor, yes. And not because it was a comeback, because they wanted more work. Let's just be clear. It wasn't.
It's always that way. Yeah, that happens a lot. We'll finish a build, and the customer will see it and go, man, you know what? Now that you see why you still have it, would you mind doing this? And a lot of people say that.
I call it since you was disease. It's since you was there.
What kind of disease? What kind of disease? What did you say?
Since you was. Since you was there.
Oh, since you was there. Okay.
Since you was there.
Yeah, a lot of people will see the same cars in the background and they're like, oh, I thought you guys gave that to the customer. Like, we did. And they wanted more stuff. So it's still here. You know, but that's a good thing. These aren't problems, you know. These are the good problems to have.
Yeah, yeah. Now, Bogey, do you guys film your show in Austin also?
No, we film in Florida.
Florida, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're about in Florida.
Just outside of Tampa.
Tampa.
In a very nondescript building. You would never know what was going on inside.
Yeah.
An undisclosed location.
Yeah.
Exactly.
What kind of reaction do you guys get from your fans? You have a fan base, I know. Shag, what do you encounter out there?
You know, I'm pretty self-aware in the fact that I'm a recognizable guy. My look is, I've always had this look. This isn't like a TV thing. My nickname's not for TV. I've been Shag since eighth grade. I've had a goatee since I'm 20. And it's kind of a recognizable look. So I get picked out of the crowd a lot and I love it.
Yeah.
And this is a blessing. This opportunity is something that we are blessed to have. And if you come up and talk to me, I'm going to take the time because I think it's amazing. And I know this all goes away.
Yeah.
I don't have any, you know, and I know that. So if you watch the show, thank you. That's amazing. And if you want to chat it up, please feel free to stop me because I love meeting people and I love talking to people. And I will say, you know, it is weird though. Costco of all places.
Yeah.
I get recognized at Costco more than anywhere else. I mean, aside from car shows.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know if it's because it's international. I don't know if it's because UT's here or, you know, there's a lot of comings and goings at the Costco, but yeah. Anytime I go in there, I get stopped a lot and I love it.
Yeah, I love Costco.
That's Home Depot for me.
Yeah. Home Depot. And Walmart. So Bogey, how about you? Any unusual fan stories?
I mean, I got to second everything that Shag said. I mean, it is just, it's been a wild ride. It's definitely, TV wasn't something that I sought out, but it has been a really interesting thing. And I'm fortunate. I have a phenomenal fan base. They're genuine and supportive and just awesome folks. And I really love it. I love talking with my fans. I love engaging with them. A lot of them have become friends. And I don't get recognized all that much out in public unless I'm in a car.
Come on.
I don't. Unless I'm in like a car event. If it's a car show or if I'm in a car, like at a car thing. And then Home Depot. Home Depot I get, and it always catches me off guard because it doesn't happen often. So yeah. I'll be just like randomly walking down the aisle in Home Depot and someone will be like, what are you doing here?
I'm like, building a porch?
Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah.
Bogey was in Austin not too long ago, last summer actually, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So Bogey was in town doing a class. She was actually teaching a class. And I hooked up with, you know, while she was in town, she came to the shop and then we went out to the Cars and Coffee out at the Circuit of the Americas track. And so in those environments, definitely, you know,
yeah.
we get stopped. But
yeah.
that was a lot of fun. It was cool to see Bogey in town. And then it was also, the timing was perfect for the car show. So that was a lot of fun.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, well, listen, it's great to have you guys on the show. And appreciate it very much. Give each of you give an invitation to new people who may be just discovering you to tune in. Give them a little teaser for the coming season. Bogey, go ahead.
All right. Well, we've got new episodes of All Girls Garage still airing on Motor Trend. And of course, you can binge watch all 9 seasons of All Girls Garage on the Motor Trend app. And you can catch up with all of my personal projects offset at Girl Gang Garage, my personal shop, and my personal pages, Bogey's Garage.
Great. Shag?
Hey, yeah, everyone follow Bogey. She does a lot of rad stuff, and I mean, I love following her and seeing what her and the girls are doing. But you can follow me. So right now, our shows are rerunning. There are reruns on the linear, like the TV network, but you can catch every season and a bunch of extras on the app. And right now, because everyone's staying home, Motor Trend has a deal where it's $1 a month for the subscription. Yeah, $1 a month. So $12 a year. So download the app because it's cool. You can see all the old biker build-offs Joe was in. You can watch all the old shows. The library is very deep on the app. So check it out. So watch our show, watch Bogey's show, and you can actually catch up on a lot of your old favorites on the app. And it can give, you know, give the shop a follow. It's at Martin Bros, Martin Bros Customs, and okay. Follow me at Shag Harrington.
Hey, thank you very much for taking time to talk with us today. And
thank you.
You guys stay safe and stay home. Until they tell us we can leave. So I've had Shag from Iron Resurrection and Buggy from All Girls Garage on the Motor Trend Network. Thanks for tuning in. This is John Butler on The Bee.
95.1 John Butler.
Cool. The Bee. Hey, thanks, guys.
Hey, thank you. That was awesome.
Yeah, we'll have to do it again.